I would say that October 1st is really an important day because we're going to see what the future of insurance in America looks like. The Affordable Care Act changes insurance law. It changes what insurance companies can do, how they can enforce, and what they can charge. And we're really going to see the future and beyond for health care in America.
We've heard about the Affordable Care Act for years, also called Obamacare. It has been debated before Congress, argued before the Supreme Court. It's a long and complicated law, and in just a few weeks, it will change the way most of us, millions of people, shop for health insurance.
So in the next hour, we hope to provide you with some useful information that we can all use to better understand what will happen on October 1st as the most sweeping parts of the act begin to take effect.
We are done. Yeah.
On March 23, 2010, President Obama signed the Affordable Care Act into law. It's the most sweeping piece of health care legislation since Medicare and Medicaid were introduced in the 1960s. And it has been challenged in Congress and the Supreme Court, yet it remains the law of the land.
It should be pretty clear by now that I didn't do this because it was good politics. I did it because I believed it was good for the country.
Some provisions of the bill have already been implemented, like extending insurance coverage to children until age 26, prohibiting denial of coverage based on pre-existing conditions, and ending the lifetime benefits cap. But the biggest changes are still to come, especially for people without health insurance.
It's going to expand coverage to many of the uninsured. There are about 50 million uninsured in this country.
Tim McBride is with Washington University's Brown School of Social Work. The expansion of coverage he's talking about begins on October 1st, when people can begin enrolling in what are being called health care exchanges. Some people will enroll while getting help from a specially trained person called a health care navigator, while others can enroll themselves online.
People describe it as like Travelocity or Expedia for health insurance. You know, if you can navigate through Expedia and Travelocity, you know, we're hopeful that that's how it'll work.
There will be different private insurance plans in different states, and premiums will be based on factors including age, number of children, and whether or not you use tobacco. Depending on income, the premium costs will be offset by federal tax credits.
By virtue of it being a large marketplace, that's what economists would call economies of scale. You get large numbers of people, you can spread the fixed costs.
About 1 in 10 Americans is expected to buy insurance through a health care exchange, with coverage taking effect on January 1st. Over time, it should result in fewer uninsured people and bring down overall health care costs. But remember, the Affordable Care Act is not universal government coverage like Medicare. Estimates are about 20 million people will still not have health insurance, either because they don't qualify, as is the case in Missouri because the state is not expanding Medicaid, or because they simply elect to pay a penalty instead of buying insurance coverage.
The law is complicated, so we have a group of experts standing by to answer your questions. You can call our hotline at this number, 1-800-782-2222. Please be patient. If the line is busy, call back and we'll try to take care of it. Joining us to help break down the new health insurance mandates are Roland Close, business editor with the Post-Dispatch, and Jim Doyle, health industry reporter with the Post. Jim has been reporting on the Affordable Health Care Act now for years. Thank you both for joining us.
Yeah, before we get into the meat of the new law, let's look at some of the basics here just so people again sort of know what we're talking about. And perhaps the first is the most obvious here. This was created to provide insurance for people that currently do not have insurance.
That's true. And let me just say at the outset that I think the takeaway from your segment is that healthcare is becoming increasingly complex for employers, employees, the self-employed, and others. And to get ahead of the curve, it's important to become a more knowledgeable consumer of healthcare, to know what your health insurance policy is, its out-of-pocket limits, its deductible, and also to become familiar with the tools that are available now, consumer tools, to compare institutions, their quality of care, and shop for price.
plan. That's all covered under the ACA, the Affordable Care Act, Obamacare, whatever you want to call
it. And it kind of gets up. One major change seems to be that instead of basing this on your health, it's now based on your income, the way health insurance will be sold through the exchanges.
It's priced, yeah. I think one of the issues, one of the things to remember is that before the Affordable Care Act was enacted, we had a significant problem in the country. There were 48, 50 million people who didn't have insurance. Those people get sick, they have children, they go to the hospital, somebody bears the cost, and before the recession started, 60% of the bankruptcies were medical related. We had a serious economic issue that was impacting business. So finding a way to broaden access was good for the economy, was good for the country.
And one of the important provisions in the Act here is that certain standards must be met in policies that are sold on the exchange and offered in the country. Why don't we go through some of those, because these are situations that affect a lot of people every day that they may not have had coverage for in previous situations. So they include things like chronic disease management, emergency services, hospitalizations, laboratory services, maternity and newborn care, mental health and substance abuse services, pediatric oral and vision care, prescription drugs, preventative and wellness services, and rehabilitative services. That is a big deal for a lot of people that may have never had that coverage at all.
It is. These policies that will be offered on the exchanges are comprehensive in nature, and some critics say they're too comprehensive. In other words, they'll be too costly for us all to afford. That's debatable. The argument in favor of preventative care, for example, is that we'll be able to catch diseases and conditions at an earlier state and try to keep folks from showing up suddenly at the emergency rooms where the care is more costly and they're further along in the disease process.
And a couple of other things like the mental health. A lot of policies don't cover that, and that will be covered. The chronic diseases, the habilitation of therapies for long-term diseases like MS or something like that. Some of those are pretty interesting changes that they've made.
I think the perception of the lawmakers behind the Affordable Care Act was that there were a lot of abuses in the health insurance industry. And part of the law was aimed at curbing those. And so the policies offered on the exchanges and also the policies that will be available in the open marketplace, especially beginning in 2014, though some of these provisions have gone into effect already, provide a full range of benefits and less
minimum thresholds, right?
Exactly. And less opportunity for the insurers to exclude people from coverage.
Yeah. Very good. Tom?
Well, we have a very informative 50 minutes still ahead, and later we'll have important phone numbers and websites for you so that you need to know about them and so you can get a pen and pencil ready to take down that information. And we have assembled some of the most knowledgeable people in the state on the health care and the new Affordable Health Care Act. So stay with us, and when we come back, we're going to get some of their expertise on this confusing, sometimes very complicated issue.
U.S. Health and Human Services Secretary Kathleen Sebelius here at St. Louis City Hall to talk about the Affordable Care Act. I sit down with her to find out how it will work.